What's going on YouTube? Jake here with Venter Visuals, and today I couldn't be more stoked to be showing you guys these three easy transitions to recreate in Adobe After Effects. So I use each of these transitions I'm about to show you guys in a variety of projects like music videos, creative edits, weddings, commercials, you name it. These transitions are very practical transitions and look good with most projects. So if you're excited to learn about these transitions, hit that like button down below and let's get right into the video. So this first transition I'm going to show you guys is just a simple wipe transition here in Adobe After Effects. As you can see here, it's a pretty simple transition. So on my timeline here, you can see this first clip is him rapping in the bedroom, and then the second clip is kind of him standing in the doorway. So the first thing you got to do is come up to your top clip and go ahead and hit the P button on your keyboard. Just keyframe the position right where it is, so this clip is perfectly aligned with this composition. Now we're going to come all the way to the end of this clip where we want the transition to end. We're just gonna go ahead and move this clip to the right, and you do want to make sure that this first clip is lined up pretty close with the edge of the composition, just like that. So now we have two keyframes. We have it right where it belongs, and then we have it wiping to the right. The next thing I like to do is just turn on motion blur for both layers. Motion blur just adds blurriness to whatever it is that you're moving around the frame. It just makes all the motion look a little more natural. So the next step is just come to your second keyframe here where this second clip is totally revealed, and we're just gonna take this parent pick whip tool and connect it to our top clip. Now this is gonna go ahead and move the second clip with the first clip. So you see that happening now. We have the first clip moving, but as it's moving, the second clip is also moving into the frame. It's not just moving out of the way and revealing the second clip. Both of these layers are moving together. Now to add some extra sauce to this, I'm gonna right click this first keyframe, come down to keyframe assistant, hit easy ease out. And I'm gonna do the same thing for the second one, except I'm gonna hit easy ease in. And now we should get a really dope wipe transition. Now you can play around with these keyframes and shorten them up or make them longer depending on how long you want your transition to happen. So technically we could make a really short transition like this, you know, very quick, or we could elongate it and make it, you know, a little longer, a little bit more time consuming. So there's a slower wipe right there. It's a pretty customizable, easy transition to make. Let's jump into the second transition. So the second transition is a mask transition. And what a mask transition is basically you're taking a clip and something is moving across the screen, whether that be a light pole, a building structure, a tree, could be anything, but you have something that's moving across the frame. So for this example, you can see here, I have this first clip on top that is my two buddies drinking some beers. And as we go over to the right, we see this light pole that starts to creep in to the frame over here on the left. So as that light pole creeps in from the left, it reveals the next clip underneath. So as you can see, it's a combination of camera movement and having something slide across your screen and also creating this mask right here to get this transition effect. Now we're just gonna recreate this from scratch. So I'm gonna go ahead and reset everything quickly here. Okay, so as you can see, our top clip is lying above our bottom clip. We wanna scroll over to where the object starts to move across the frame. So as you can see, this light pole is really moving across the frame right at this moment. So with that clip selected, we're just gonna go ahead and hit this rectangle tool. Now you can also use the pen tool to make a mask, but for this example, we're just gonna use this rectangle tool. And we're just gonna make this rectangle across the entire frame, just like that. So that's gonna be our first mask point. So now with our mask one selected underneath our layer, we're gonna go ahead and hit a keyframe under the mask point like that. And now we're just gonna scroll to the very end where the light pole is basically out of the frame. We're gonna come up here to our selection tool. We're gonna move these points that we've created for this mask on the left. We're gonna move them all the way to time up with the lamp. So you can see now we have the mask moving with the lamp across the screen. Now it's not perfect, and I can see here it's definitely not connected to the pole as good as it could be. So what I normally like to do is spend some time on this masking process where I'm just going to all these individual points, looking for anything that looks off, and I'm adjusting the keyframes for this mask path. So this part could take you some time depending on how smooth or how clunky your camera movement is. For me, definitely spending, you know, 10 to 20 minutes on a mask transition is not uncommon. So for the sake of this example, I'm just gonna make this one pretty quick. And as you can see, we're almost good. Now at the very beginning, we do have to clear up this edge a little bit, so we're just gonna bring it over here. And again, it's making keyframes for our mask path down here. So as the pull moves, the mask moves across the screen with the pull. So that's about it, guys. Now, in order to make this a little bit smoother, I do like to have motion blur turned on. And then I also like to feather the mask by a few pixels. So we're just gonna feather a mask by about 10 pixels here. And that just gives it more of a natural motion blur along the edge. So if we watch this back in full motion, you can see exactly what it's doing. Moving on to our third transition, we're gonna go ahead and experiment with a rotoscope transition. Now, this is a little bit more advanced than the beginner transitions that I've shown you today. You can see that our first clip is this clip of this car, and then we have the rotoscope effect happening, and then it transitions into the next clip seamlessly. So we're just gonna go ahead and watch this in full motion one time, just so you guys can get a taste of what this effect looks like in full motion. So pretty cool, pretty easy, creative way to transition into your next clip. We're gonna go ahead and just delete this rotoscope layer for now. Just gonna go ahead and get rid of it. Now you'll see that we have this car layer and then it snaps into this next clip right here. And what we need to do is drag this second clip a few frames above our car clip. And then what we need to do is come to this cut. We need to hit Command Shift D right where this cut is, so that our rotoscope layer is going to be separated from the clip that we're transitioning to. So you can see here we have our car layer, and then we have our rotoscope layer that we're gonna do, and then we have our next clip right here. So what we need to do from here is just take our rotoscope layer. We need to come up here to our roto brush tool and double click. Now what you need to do here is just trace around whoever or whatever it is that you're going to be using to transition into the next clip. The roto brush is one of my favorite tools in Adobe After Effects. You can get really creative with it and make a lot of unique transitions once you master rotoscoping. So if you've never used the roto brush before, I highly recommend just kind of messing around with it. It's really not that intimidating to use, and you can achieve some really cool results. So as you can see here, I'm just going around his edges and just making sure that the cutout of him looks good and we're not getting any rough edges around his body. So what we're gonna do is we're just gonna hit 2 on our keyboard, and this is gonna take us frame by frame in our composition. So you can see After Effects is actually tracing each frame itself. I'm not having to trace each frame. After Effects is doing a good job at just kind of guessing where I want the tracings to happen. Now I do usually go frame by frame and just check to make sure After Effects doesn't grab something random in the background and incorporates that into the tracing. Now we do get like these little areas with his arms where you can see some of the background. So what I like to do to get rid of any areas that the roto brush tool is taking up is I hold option on my keyboard and just drag over those areas, and that brings up this red brush instead of the green brush you can see right there. And when you have the red brush turned on with the option key, you can delete areas. We are at the last frame of this roto brush rotoscope. So now if we hop back over here into our composition, you can see we now have him cut out of the rest of the background and he's appearing over the car layer. So what we need to do now is with this rotoscope layer, we're just gonna go ahead and hit P on our keyboard, and we're gonna keyframe the position, and we're gonna drag this point to the very last frame. And now on the very first frame of this rotoscope layer, we're gonna go ahead and keyframe our position to be a little bit lower down, so he kind of slides up into the frame just like that. Now what I do like to do is I right click this first keyframe and hit easy ease out, and I right click this second keyframe and I'll hit easy ease in. And you do want to make sure that motion blur is turned on for this. So now when I play it back, you can see it's pretty seamless transition, and it works really good for music videos, creative edits, any type of video where you're trying to get a little bit artsy. And that's about all I had for today, guys. I really appreciate you guys tuning in and watching this tutorial. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit that like button down below. And if you edit videos and you're looking to add some sauce to your edits, check out my website, venturevisuals.com. I got overlays, transitions, light leaks, and a bunch of other stuff on there, all of which you can try completely for free. I'll include a link down below. And if you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing to my channel. I'm really trying to grow this community of video editors and creatives. And everybody who hits that subscribe button, it lets me know that I'm doing a good job with my videos and that I should keep making more. So definitely consider hitting that subscribe button and helping me build this community. And again, guys, I really appreciate your time today. Until next time, I'm Jake Benner. Peace out.